Now, when you do these markings, sometimes, you know, when I'm doing this, I actually don't know what I'm doing because I've not actually done it for such a long time that it's sort of new to me as well. So when I laid this out, although I planned to do, you know, all of a sudden I planned to do this, and I was at a loss at what I'm doing. Now, I have to try and recollect what measurements I was going to use for this top, what did I call it, I even forget the names. Now the measurements that I am using is, this is the back, is double folded, and this is the back chest area, shoulder area. I needed this 18 inches ready, so what I've done is I've marked this off at 9 inches. Now from this 9 inches, I've curved it in to the total length of the upper area, which I'm using, you know what, momentarily, that even the name has actually escaped me. It's about 7.5 inches, and at that 7.5 inch, if I measure it across, I have done this at 10.5 inches. So 10.5 inches from there, I've curved it out to the shoulder area, and then this I've curved it to the neck area. The neck width I have kept here at 2.5 inches, which makes it to 5 inches. When stitched, this will have an opening of 6 inches. So here at 3.5, from that 3.5 inches, I have measured it in. That 3.5 inches has been 9 inches going from one side and 2.5 inches from the other side. I've put a mark on there, and then from there to the top of the shoulder, I have just marked it across with a slant. The neck is to the top of the shoulder, up to the neck where the hood is going to be attached, is 4 inches. That 4 inches is curved in 2 inches, and then sort of rounded off to the 2.5 inches. So basically, this is the measurements that I'm using. It's actually measurements that are experimental measurements, because I don't have, this isn't the measurement that I took for Yasser, and he's not here, but going through past experience, I actually quite distinctly remember making this in this manner. I will show you what this will look like once it's cut and it's laid open, and it will give you more of an idea of what I'm talking about for the yoke. That was the word. Momentarily, I had even escaped my mind what I was saying. Now, the reason why I had curved that was because I needed to get, now if I put that back again, now you'd understand it a lot better how I meant, what I meant about having a yoke going at the top. And basically, this is what I was talking about. Now around here, I'm going to attach the back of the dress. Around here, I'm going to attach the front of the dress. Around here, I'm going to be attaching the hood, which will be sort of going on from the center of the back like this, attaching all the way to the front of the opening. So this is the curve of the neckline around here, and this will help the whole garment to sit very evenly. There won't be any seams on the shoulder. This, all these seams will be all seamed on the inside. So this is attaching a yoke on to a garment, and I will show you what the garment itself will look like once this is attached. And you master some of these skills, and let me assure you that you are on your way to being a very, very much of a professional tailor, because you know what, these are just some of the skills that I use in male tailoring. Now, the only thing that I need to do now is actually, the armhole is slightly bit longer than what I had hoped. So I'm going to cut this down a little bit, approximately an inch off, because this is slightly bit longer than that. that sort of, once this is all seamed, this will be more or less right. So the only thing now I need to do is the front of the garment. I need to cut into this, center this and cut into this, where I will be putting the zip in later on. I will be putting one pocket on at the top there. The sleeves will be the checked design. The hood will be the checked design, and it'll be a combination of like the blue and the white combination of jubba. It will have no other seams apart from the zip at the front, one pocket there and two side pockets on either sides. So this will be quite relatively easy to make once we've actually done the initial preparations.